Hey, what's up, Abby Fest? It's Matt Marr. How's everybody doing tonight? What holds your heart? What stirs your soul? What matters come to mind? Cares you keep, the thought you think, it's not a wasted time. Seeking you will find, joy still comes in the morning, hope still walks with the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, lost away from home. A father finds the child inside. We left for growing old. Awake, 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 my soul. Joy still comes in the morning. Hope still the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, praise the Lord. Don't stop dancing and dreaming. Still good news worth repeating. Lift your head and keep singing. Praise the Lord. Let everything praise the Lord. Poor, well, it don't matter, weak or strong. It's good to be with you, even if it's just virtually, and even if I can't see your face, even if I can't hear you sing along. It's still the weirdest thing to me about doing stuff like this, about sharing songs, and that's the thing I miss the most. It's the thing I quickly realized how much I missed when this quarantine started. It's a weird thing when you write songs, and a big part of the reason why you write them is so that people can sing them together. And then just to be singing them into the ether by yourself. But I think that's the thing about worship that is powerful, is that even if it's just our own voice, the reality is we're never singing alone. Because worship's something that, not so much that it's something that we start as much as it's something that we step into. And it's a reality that's eternally happening in heaven. So maybe as we sing this next song, we just join our voices with what's going on up there. Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters and till mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough, your grace is enough for me. For me, great is your love and justice, God of Jacob. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us in the song of your salvation. remember you, God. I recall your goodness over all my life. I recall your faithfulness over all my life. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. God, I see your grace is enough. Heaven reaches down to earth. Your grace. It's enough for me. Yeah, I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I ever you calling in. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will own your people in my heart. Here I am. Is it I, Lord? I ever you calling in the night? I will go, Lord, if you leave. I will hold your people in my heart. I will hold your people in my heart. Be the song I sing, be my guiding light, Savior of my soul, be the Lord of my life. Every step I take, always by my side, I am yours, you are mine, be the Lord of my life. Oh,
next song is a new song that's part of a new album that came out called Alive and Breathing, and it was sort of a live album and with some new songs in there. And this year, it was going to be a special year. I mean, it's been a unique year for everybody, but for me, it was this year is my 10-year wedding anniversary. And this year marks 25 years since I moved to the United States from Canada. And this year was the year that I gave my heart to God, I think, in a meaningful way. And the thing I've realized 25 years later is that it's something that you pretty much have to do every day, almost every minute. Because it's easy to surrender your finances when you're a college student and don't have any money. And it's easy to surrender your view of marriage when you're not married. It's easy to surrender what it means to be a dad when you don't have kids. It's easy to say, oh God, I'll, you know, if you do this for me, I'll thank you on the back end. But it's just a whole different ballgame when you find yourself in a situation. And after 20 years, or 25 years, I've realized that my heart is like a million different kingdoms. And if I'm not careful, I'll put me on the throne of every single one of them. So I wrote this song last year as kind of a way, I think, for me to kind of, knowing this year was coming up, and kind of as a way to dedicate it and saying that, man, I need Jesus to be Lord of every part of my life, not just one part. And I think especially right now more than ever before, because I was talking about this earlier today with a friend of mine and saying that, you know, along the way, God can reveal things about our hearts and about our lives that we haven't let him be Lord of. And he kind of, sometimes he exposes those things. Kind of as an act of mercy, really. So maybe some of us, we've let our worldview be defined by politics or money or status or the, you know, you take your pick. Maybe Jesus is asking you if you'd let him be Lord of everything. That's what this song's about. It's called Lord of My Life. Sky without a north star, ship without an anchor, caught up in the current, my heart is prone to wander. All these roads I've taken lead me back to nowhere. You're the destination, you're the way to get there. You can have it all. Be the song I sing, be my guiding light, Savior of my soul, be the Lord of my life. Every step I take, always by my side, I am yours and you are mine. Be the Lord of my life. Love, we love, why?
watch it break on through. I wanna go where you go, wanna move where you move. Wanna love where you love, watch it break on through. I wanna go where you go, wanna move where you move. Wanna love where you love, watch it break on through. I wanna go where you go, wanna move where you move. Watch it break on through.
Confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. My sin runs deep. Your grace is more. Your grace is found. Is where you are. Where you are, Lord, I yield free. Holiness is Christ in me. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. So teach my song to rise to you. When temptation comes my way. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my right.
Oh God, how I need you. You're my one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. Think of all the times I've been at Abbey Fest and I've sung that song during adoration or right before it. And there's something about, you know, being with you guys and sharing these songs on the weekend, the Feast of Corpus Christi. And we think about the gift of Jesus in the Eucharist and what the Eucharist, or who the Eucharist is, and but what the Eucharist represents, which is the union with Christ, but it's the unity of the church. And I know a lot of people have really struggled during this quarantine with not being able to receive the Eucharist. And I remember during Holy Week this year, kind of in the midst of prayer, I felt like God gave me a thought that I'd never really thought about before. That I felt like Jesus was saying to me, hey, listen, a lot of people are going to focus this week on Holy Week about how they can't receive me in the Eucharist. But not a lot of people are going to think about my longing for them. The idea that God would institute the Eucharist and 2,000 years later, there'd be a moment when he would want to give himself, but we wouldn't be able to receive. And sort of that being a window into the sense of loneliness that Jesus felt in the Garden of Gethsemane after instituting the Eucharist and giving himself, knowing there would come a time. Something like that is sort of a hard thing to think about, but if you can allow yourself the space to kind of step into that, I think it's a real gift from God. And I think it gives the loneliness that we have in times like this, seasons like this, moments like this in human history, it gives it a greater sense of depth and meaning and purpose. Because otherwise, you know, apart from the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus, our suffering, it doesn't make any sense. It has no meaning. So as I sing this next song, if you've found your heart heavy, you know, these past few months, and even right now with all the unrest that's going on and all the, you know, sort of continual wounds being revealed about the very real sin of racism in our country and the pain that people are feeling, fear, the anxiety, my advice, but my encouragement to you is to go to God with it and realize that he can meet you in your anxiety and your fear, and it doesn't magically go just disappear, but Jesus knows what it's like because he carried that anxiety and fear in the garden. So we have a God who understands, and he wants us to run to him. Even if sometimes in the running to him, stuff gets exposed in us that needs to be dealt with. I think the end result is love and transformation and conversion. I've carried a burden too long on my own.
I wasn't created to bury it alone. I hear your invitation to let it all go. I see it now, I'm laying it down. I know that I need you. I've run to the Father, fallen to grace. I'm done with the hiding, a reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, oh, oh. You saw my condition, had a plan from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. Tell the Father, I'm falling to grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, oh.
Oh, amen.
Let my song join the world and never end, because he lives. I believe in the sun. I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome by the power of his blood. Song for you, and I think I've ended every time I've played since I wrote this song with this song. Did that make sense? I just want to be an encouragement to you and say there's power in the presence of God, but it's most powerful when the people of God are united. A.W. Tozer said, where brothers dwell in unity, God commands a blessing. And we need people to dwell in unity right now, but sometimes we gotta, any family, if there's stuff in the family that is getting in the way of us being in unity, it's good to talk about it. It's good to bring it out, get it out into the light. And I look at what's happening in our country right now, and getting to come near Philly every year with Abbey Fest, and it's the city of brotherly love. I have two sons and they're brothers, and sometimes love looks real rough. But the thing is, when you love someone, you're willing to stick it out. You're willing to stick it through the hard times. And when your brother's hurting, you're willing to stop and just listen. And sometimes it feels like that's just the simplest thing to do, but the most overlooked. And right now in our country, the Black community is hurting. They've been hurting for a long time. And more than anything, first and foremost, what they just need is people who are willing to just listen. And I can't think of a better group of people than people who see, whose faith dictates that every human life has dignity. Every human life has purpose. No one's forsaken, no one's forgotten. And so as we kind of walk this moment out, we pray for the courage to confront the things that need to be confronted and to get them out into the light, get them out in the open. And that includes the sin of racism and all the ways it's kind of permeated throughout our society and affected the way that we see one another and the way that we live. And I think that God, when we do that and we do that hard work and we don't try to brush it aside, but we kind of allow ourselves to sit in and own what we need to own, I think it's in those moments of honesty that are also hard and painful, that's when the mercy of God can really start shining in and bring about a great work of healing. So be encouraged in the midst of this. I know it feels like there's so much division. And maybe in the church we could help model some of that reconciliation, right? Maybe in the church we could start to model what it looks like to listen to one another, to try to hear one another, to empathize with one another, to believe one another. This is the first day of the rest of your life. This is the first day of the rest of your life. 'Cause even in the dark, you can still see the light. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. This is the first day of the rest of your life. This is the first day of the rest of your life. See it in the dark, you can still see the light. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. It's waiting for you. Knocking at your door in a moment of truth, when your heart is the floor and you're on your knees in love. Well, hold us together.
of the rest of your life. There since the first day of the rest of your life. Cause even in the dark, you can still see the light. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. Oh, love will hold us together, make us a shelter to weather the storm. And I'll be my brother's keeper, so the whole world will know that we're not alone.
God bless you guys. Thanks so much for listening and singing and praying with me. Have a great summer, and hopefully we'll see you soon. God bless Abbey Fest. Take care. Bye.